Thank you for watching The Night Beat. I'm Emma Heaton.
And I'm Russ McCaskey. It seems almost impossible to opt out of political text. They say that you can text STOP, but that's not stopping another number from messaging you.
The Night Beat's Haley Zarcone joins us live in studio. Haley, how do political organizations get your number to begin with?
One expert told me that it may be through your voter registration. And the closer we get to Election Day, the more texts that some seem to get. Political campaigning has come a long way, and it's starting a buzz at the polls.
The days of campaign posters and newspaper ads are long gone.
They're certainly not subscribing to print newspapers like they used to. So campaigns are having to figure out more creative ways to get to voters. Social media or text seems to be one of the ways that they've landed on.
If it's on the ballot, it's in your messages.
I deleted a couple of this today, but they were like, just go out and vote, speak your mind.
I get a few. I might get one or two a day, but like I said, my daughter, she gets 50 to 60.
Get this. His daughter is years away from voting, too.
She's 10. She freaks out. She doesn't like it. She wishes I could block them. I'm like, I try to send stop to one and 10 more show up.
So can you drown out the noise and still make a sound decision?
Certainly they are trying to sway voters, but they also know that a lot of voters have already made up their mind, and so it's just mobilizing them to actually vote.
It's what we're supposed to do, and you know, we want to support each other, especially as people, and we all deserve a right. Ignore the text and go with what your heart desires.
Individually by replying stop like you see here. However, that's not always foolproof. But once Election Day is here and results are in, that's when your notifications should get a little less political. Back to you.